I tend to do a lot of reflection before I apologize, because I want to make sure that I'm apologizing for the right thing.
Oh, not delaying that you've got to admit that you're wrong.
No.
Okay.
No. If I know that I'm wrong.
I was in there a little bit.
Well,
I think with you it's in there a little bit, because I know with me it is.
Listen.
I think in there a little bit you're going to see.
When I say that I do not intentionally try to hurt someone's feelings, it is because I am not speaking and trying to be wrong. I am trying to make sure that what I am saying is right, because I like to be right. I don't like
you
to have
do
to.
I do.
And I will fight tooth and freaking nail if I think I'm right in something. Now, when I get proven wrong, then I have to figure out, what am I apologizing for? Am I apologizing because I took it too far when I knew I was probably wrong? Am I apologizing for what maybe I said?
Okay.
Am I apologizing for not listening to the other person? Like, there are a million different things I could apologize for. So I want to make sure I'm apologizing for the right thing, because there's nothing worse than being a person like me who hates to apologize. To apologize to you for something, and then you look at me and go, that's not what I'm mad about. Now,
man.
I just fucking apologized for something I didn't need to, and now I still have to give you another apology. I don't like that shit.
See? So there is a little bit in there that you're waiting to make sure that if you've got to get down to that level of apology.
I need to make sure I'm apologizing for the right thing.
The apology was, I'm sorry that hurt you.
I'm sorry that you took it that way. I'm sorry that what I said, not even that, I'm sorry you heard it that way. I'm sorry you feel that
I'm
way.
I'm sorry you feel that way,
I'm
right?
I'm sorry what I said made you feel that way.
Because that way you're still never wrong.
You're not wrong.
You didn't do anything wrong. And in fact, you're putting it back on them.
I would gouge your eyes out.
They took it the wrong way because you were an asshole.
That is a terrible way to apologize, because you're not apologizing.
No, it's not good. And where what broke me, well, mainly broke. I still do it sometimes, but I really try not to. But what really broke me of that was Eileen.
Oh, sure.
Because in our early marriage, oh my God, you know, you get, and I think almost any marriage can attest to this, you get out of that first year or two, and all of a sudden, holy shit, you guys are like two prize fighters in a ring. Yes, I mean, every day you're just knocking the shit out of each other.
Knock down, drag God. Out, fight.
You know what I mean? It's just like, Jesus. And so, but that was always mine. It was just, I'd never admit that you're wrong. Or you say sorry, kinda, to get them talking so that you could then prove that you really didn't have to apologize because they were wrong.
And this is why you and I could never be married.
No,
because
no.
I'm thinking the whole time while you're saying, well, I'm sorry you feel that way. I'm A, thinking of ways to murder you, but B, also thinking of ways to get you to talk that I can say why you're wrong.
Yes.
So. It wouldn't work
so
out
that's
very
the
well.
Way it would be. Like, we'd be go right. on for hours and hours like that, yeah, until we were
divorced.
Or that or in the grave.
One or
the
other.
Two. Jesus. So, anyway, so she finally kind of came to me, and then also through, you know, therapy, you know, they kind of finally broke down to me, like, hey, that is not the way you work things out with a loved one or a friend or those kind of things. You know, if you've hurt them, and this was actually really cool. Somebody said to me once, it was like in a marriage class that was kind of almost like therapy. And they said to me, I don't care what she says she feels. That's where you have to start.
Yep.
Right. So even if you're looking at her saying, I don't feel that way, that's irrelevant.
It
because the other
is.
Person in the relationship feels that way.
Yep.
So you've got to start there.
You do.
Whether who's ever right or wrong doesn't really matter. You've got to start with what...
Their feelings are valid.
It can't be negated.
Nope.
You can't tell somebody they don't feel what they feel.
Nope.
So I think that's somewhere, too, that I can get a little bit concerned. Because as we learn and grow, like, sometimes I realize that should have been an apology.
But that's good that you're recognizing that, right?
What about that poor person a year ago
They've
that I fucking trampled
it.
On?
They've gotten over it. And if they haven't, then you know they haven't.
That's true.
And then you can go back and apologize.
You can go back. That's true.
You know, I mean, there are... But let's face it. There are some situations in life where somebody should apologize for something, but they never get the chance to say that apology.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a fact of life. You know?
It
is something that you'll have to... learn to live with. Try to live your life so that you aren't leaving situations where you should have been table. Apologizing, right?
Yeah, no, that makes sense. Okay, so let's take it. So say you and Brandon get in a fight or an altercation or a disagreement, whatever we want to call it to sound proper.
A tiff.
How long does it usually take you once you know you're wrong to say sorry?
You know, as of late, not very long at all.
Same here.
You know, a couple years ago, a little bit longer.
Yep.
You know, tens of years ago.
Right.
A lot longer.
A long time.
Like, I remember in the beginning of our relationship, and even towards the middle, there was a lot of silent treatment.
Right. Oh, yeah.
I can't remember the last time we gave each other silent treatment.
Yeah, no.
It just doesn't, pointless. After being together for as long as we've been together, we fought about just about everything you can fight about.
Right. Yeah.
So if there is a situation that requires an apology, it's almost an immediate.
Yeah.
I knew it when I said it.
Right.
And
yeah.
I should not have said that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I am so sorry. And then it's a thank you. Thank
right.
you for recognizing
right.
that. But that's because we've learned how to talk that way.
Yeah.
Because we have worked at it. We've gone to therapy. We've put it in practice.
Yes.
You know, we've worked on it. But yeah, I mean, God. 7 years ago.
Right.
No.
Yeah. So same.
I mean,
yeah,
that's
funny.
Like you guys?
Same thing for me. And Eileen's different because she's somebody, same kind of thing. And she's even fully admit this, that she's one of those that are quick to say sorry about everything. Apologize.
Yes,
apologize.
She does.
And that was pre-programming from her childhood.
Yes, it was.
And so, and mine was pre-programming the opposite way. Mm-hmm. Even if you mess up, you don't ever apologize. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That kind of almost mentality. Right.
Right?
So, you know, so, but same thing, 10 years ago, No, I'll apologize once you apologize for something. Even if it was all me, we're going to find something you need to apologize for, and then I'll apologize.
We're both doing this.
I'm not doing this alone.